that you sell, how payment gateway suits you or doesn't suit you. Now, what are the type of providers? Providers are basically, there's financial institutes, just you directly bank ko approach karoge. So banks, there are many banks in India which doesn't provide a payment gateway. But the only drawback of approaching a bank is they need high volumes. Now, a question, what is high volume? Even I don't know because they are not very clear on that. Everyone has a different logic. Kabhi-kabhi they say ke a monthly 10,000 is also a good number for them, but sometimes they say 10 lakh is a minimum requirement. So that's a very, you know, specific question going to that bank and understanding. But bank, the only drawback in bank is that aapko sirf, as per RBI, as I said, India mein RBI dictates a lot of things in all these processes. So RBI ka ek mandate hai ke financial institutes can only provide a payment gateway for cards. तो बेसिकली फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूट के पास अगर आप जाओगे तो आपको सिर्फ क्रेडिट या डेबिट कार्ड का एक्सेप्टेंस होगा. नेट बैंकिंग एंड अदर मीडियम्स आर ऑफिशियली नॉट अलाउड. इफ समवन इज फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री दे आस्क मी आईसीआईसीआई गिव्स मी, दैट इज बिकॉज आईसीआईसीआई डजंट डू इट देमसेल्फ, दे डू इट थ्रू अ थर्ड पार्टी. सो बैंकिंग इंस्टीट्यूट विल ओनली गिव यू अ कार्ड, डेबिट एंड क्रेडिट कार्ड प्रोसेसिंग. What's a payment aggregator? Payment aggregator, the word itself. So there is this there are many companies, institutes who provide you with a complete solution. What is a complete solution? आपने जो type of payments देखे, so they, you know, कोई कोई aggregators रहेंगे जो सिर्फ आपको ऊपर के दो या तीन देंगे, कोई कोई रहेंगे जो आपको सब देंगे, कोई कोई रहेंगे they have a own set of payment methods that they'll allow you to do. So the organization which allows you multiple payment methods is a person who does an aggregation. The thing about aggregators is that आपका process payment flow जो आपने start में देखा internally, not to the end user, आपके buyer को इससे कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा, but as a merchant, as a seller, अगर आप seller के point of view से देख रहे हो, तो seller के point of view से एक aggregator होने की वजह से क्या होता है, एक additional step आ जाता है आपके payment flow में. It's a micro millisecond difference, but there's an additional payment flow that comes into the picture because what's happening is आपके वेबसाइट से एग्रीगेटर के वेबसाइट पे जाता है एंड एग्रीगेटर के वेबसाइट से, as I said, eventually at the end RBI only allows card processing through financial institute. तो इसलिए एग्रीगेटर को भी has to go to a financial institute. So that's the additional page that comes in or a process that comes in. So that's the only difference. And the major advantage with an aggregator is that you get all the products that are available in the industry because they are poorly doing that. What are e-wallets? This is the new trend. It's like the thing right now. Everyone has an e-wallet. E-wallet is nothing but a digital currency. It's a virtual, not digital currency, my bad, sorry. E-wallet कुछ नहीं, but आपका जो physical, आपका जो money है, वो एक prepaid account. जैसे postpaid billing होता है, वैसे एक prepaid account होता है. Same way, for payments, e-wallet is nothing but एक online बटवा जिसके अंदर आपने पैसे already डाल के रखे हुए हैं. As simple as that. That telecom aggregators is something that is not yet explored in India that much, but yes, India does have aggregators for telecom operators. Now, ये क्या है? Telecom operators is nothing, aggregators are nothing, but there are जैसे अपने payment gateway के aggregators है, a company which deals with XYZ banks and deals with many financial institutes. Same way, telecom aggregators are companies जो telecom operators के साथ interaction और provide करते हैं उनका service. तो उसमें एडवांटेज क्या है, जैसे आपका बाकी के जो सिस्टम्स है उसमें आपके पैसे आपके बैंक में होने चाहिए या कार्ड में होने चाहिए. द डिफरेंस इन दिस इज दैट ये जो है वो आपके डायरेक्ट, अगर आपका बिलिंग है तो बिलिंग अकाउंट में ऐड हो जाता पैसा, बट देयर आर लिमिटेशंस, देयर इज अ अमाउंट लिमिटेशन, तो यू कैन नॉट हैव एन हायर लिमिट रहता है, बट डिपेंडिंग आपके अग्रीमेंट पे. सो बट अगर आपकी स्मॉल अमाउंट वैल्यूज है, समझो आपका 2000 के नीचे का कोई प्रोडक्ट है और आपके कार्ड्स है, सो दिस वन न्यू ऑप्शन दैट यू गाइस कैन एक्सप्लोर जो इंडिया में अब तक ज्यादा हुआ नहीं है. प्रोवाइडर्स है बट पीपल आर नॉट अवेयर एंड दैट्स द रीजन. सो इफ यू वांट टू कम अप विद अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट एंड अ न्यू आइडिया, आपको कुछ अलग हटके बनना है, तो दिस वन थिंग दैट यू कैन एक्सप्लोर. टेलीकॉम एग्रीगेटर्स हुआ दे दैट यू कैन हैव अ डिफरेंट डिस्कशन. सो अगर आपका प्रीपेड कार्ड है तो आपके प्रीपेड मोबाइल कार्ड, आई एम सेइंग, आई एम नॉट सेइंग अ डिजिटल वॉलेट, इट्स अ मोबाइल कार्ड जो आपका सिम कार्ड रहता है आप फोन में डालते हो, वो सिम कार्ड का जो बैलेंस है उसमें से कटता है, और अगर आपका बिलिंग है तो आपके नेक्स्ट बिलिंग साइकिल के बिल में वो अमाउंट डालना है एज अ कॉमर्स ट्रांजैक्शन, ई कॉमर्स ट्रांजैक्शन. दैट्स योर एडवांटेज. एंड Airtel Money, okay, by the questions are open, so you can always just open questions. Airtel Money or Vodafone M-Pesa, they are not टेलीकॉम एग्रीगेटर, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट सिस्टम, दैट्स अगेन ई वॉलेट सिस्टम. उसमें भी कैसा है, आपको एक डिजिटल वॉलेट दिया जाता है फ्रॉम एयरटेल मनी और वोडाफोन एम-पैसा. तो उनमें है कि जैसे हमने ई वॉलेट डिस्कस किया, आपका एक अकाउंट रहता है उनके साथ एंड उसमें आप पैसे रिफिल करते हो. यू पुट मनी इन इट इंटेंशनली टू बी यूज ओनली फॉर एम कॉमर्स, इट्स कॉल्ड एम कॉमर्स. But then that's the only idea behind it. They are different. They are not telecom aggregator. Telecom aggregators, जैसे मैंने आपको explain किया कि आपके billing account में से आपका जो billing statement आता है phone का, उसमें वो add होता है पैसा. As well as अगर prepaid account रहेगा तो आपके prepaid balance रहता है, आप call करते हो cut होता है, SMS देखते हो cut होता है. Same way आपने shopping किया वो पैसा आपके balance से cut होता है. That is what is the difference between M-Paisa and your M-Commerce, and this doesn't have a term as such yet in the slang way, but telecom operator payments is what it is roughly called as.
What all is not allowed on payment gateways to be sold?
Okay, so that's a very big list for that. But every provider, there's a generic list jo RBI ke paas se aata hai, plus aggregators ya financial institute apne khud ke risk factor ke hisab se add karte hai. But on a very rough and a very common sense understanding, your things like firearms, your drugs in a sense, not only drug, it's also pharmacy. So pharmacy or vice drugs also, any of those nature is not allowed. Your adult content in India is not allowed to be sold. Your there are some restrictions on copyright products. So if you, so there's like a gray area, like if you want to sell DVDs, you can, but there's some different understanding on that. So that's, again, there are many gray areas which need to be worked out. So always either the best person to give you a direct answer for these very specific questions would be your aggregator whom you're trying to call, get involved with, or aggregator can help you the best over there, because har ek aggregator ya financial institute ka alag list rehta hai, but there's a generic list. You can go on the rbi.org.in. there is a, I don't have a specific URL for that, but it is there listed on the RBI port ke kya kya products are not allowed. And roughly abroad, any aggregator, like we deal with whoever aggregators, there's roughly a 42 products ka list that they say is not allowed. Most of the aggregators have a list of 42 item list which is not allowed by default, but as I said, aggregator ke hisab se change hote rahega. What is the acquiring process? Am I going too fast?
No.
Am I just babbling?
No.
I think so, I'm babbling, but if I'm not making sense or if any specific questions, open. Okay. No, because this is, as I said, very compact, so there's a slide, then we can take more open kind of a discussion with question answers, because it's just 20 minutes that I have. Acquiring process, first is confirm your constitution. Constitution kya hai? In India, as you know, you can have a firm or a company or an individual. So individual started in September 2013, uske pehle individuals are not allowed to have a payment gateway. September 2013, you are allowed. So agar aapko savings account ke saath aapko payment accept karna hai, is allowed now. So agar koi misunderstanding hai, get it over. Agar aapko khud ka home shop, aapke ghar se kuch start karna hai, you can do that now without having a current account. Second is firms. Firms, there are two firms in India that are recognized, partnership firm and a proprietary firm. अगर आपको प्रोफेशनल बनना है, यू हैव टू हैव अ प्रोफेशनल सेटअप एंड यू नो यू हैव अ कंपनी एंड विद अ करंट अकाउंट एंड हाई वॉल्यूम्स, यू कैन हैव अ करंट अकाउंट विद अ प्रोप्राइटरी फर्म. और इफ यू आर विद वन मोर पर्सन और मोर देन वन पर्सन, यू कैन हैव अ पार्टनरशिप फर्म. द थर्ड एज आई सेड इज अ कंपनी विच इज योर यू नो मिनिस्ट्री रजिस्टर्ड, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट रजिस्टर्ड कंपनी विच इज अ प्राइवेट लिमिटेड, और यू नो द इन अगेन सेप्टेम्बर यू कैन ऑल्सो हैव अ वन पर्सन कंपनी,
OPC,
which is one person company, and private limited, LLP, OPC limited, depend on your state, and corporates, your associates. Again, if someone is into NGO or something in social activities or something, there are a lot of restrictions that are there. बहुत से आपको RBI की तरफ से norms follow करने पड़ते हैं, licenses extra लेने पड़ते हैं to get an online payment gateway. which your aggregator आप जो choose करोगे या call करोगे you'll have it and just they'll give you every aggregator will have a different जैसे मैं बता but license से ज़्यादा करते हैं so if anyone having an NGO planning to have an NGO over here okay one thing that you can think of doing for the social cause in the later stages so yes so you should know what constitution because आपका documentation process आपके many things will vary as per what your constitution is because your risk factor varies as per what constitution you hold come under. Selecting the provider. I just roughly brush through that. I'll again come back to that if we have the time. Which is what provider? You know, like as I said, there are various kind of providers, aggregators, banking institute, e-wallet providers. So that you can take a call on depending on your product, what you want to sell, what you want to margin. Select a package. हर एग्रीगेटर के पास कुछ ना कुछ इफ यू आर गोइंग विद एन एग्रीगेटर और विद अ बैंक और एनी ऑफ द प्रोवाइडर्स एवरीवन हैव अ यू नो अ स्टार्टर पैकेज एंड अ एंटरप्राइज पैकेज एंड समथिंग इन बिटवीन तो आपका कैपेसिटी आपका यूसेज आपका टर्नओवर व्हाट यू थिंकिंग आपके प्रोजेक्ट का क्या टर्नआउट का टर्नओवर होने वाला है डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट आप पैकेज सेलेक्ट कर सकते हो इट्स नॉट देयर बट आई जस्ट गो अहेड then there's something. Yeah, you select a package, then documents, right? It's financial. There's a lot of monetary value involved with it. There's a lot of high security involved in it. So they need all the documentation in place. So everyone has their own set of documents. What are allowed? What are allowed? Again, RBI has a minimum KYC mandate. So जैसे आपको एक bank account खोलना है, वो हर एक document bank account खोलने के लिए जो लगेगा यहाँ पे भी लगेगा. Plus, आपको bank account भी लगेगा. So that's an additional step. After getting a bank account, you need this to and a bank account with that. Then एक बार ये process हो जाता है, आप agreement sign करते हो, you then everyone will give you आपका एक बार डॉक्यूमेंटेशन और अग्रीमेंट हो गया देन आफ्टर दैट आपको टेस्टिंग के लिए वो एक लॉगिन देंगे टेस्टिंग के बाद यू कैन गो लाइव दैट्स इट वेरी सिंपल प्रोसेस इट माइट टेक टाइम हर एग्रीगेटर का अलग सिस्टम रहता है फ्रॉम एनीवेयर फ्रॉम 3 डेज टू इवन हाई रिस्क वैल्यू अगर रहेगा तो ऑलमोस्ट अप टू 40 डेज भी लगता है ऑन अप्रूवल सो दैट्स अ ब्रीफ ऑफ व्हाट इट इज कमिंग बैक टू व्हाट एनी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस पीपल हैव यस
Like you said, individuals are allowed and companies are allowed. So we have like a preference for individual which aggregator to use versus.
Good question. Actually, it's there. Okay, but the thing is, कैसा है उसमें? If you are an individual, there are not every provider. Oh my bad. Actually, everyone has slowly started moving and coming to individuals. But over here, since it was a basic one, I didn't want to take out names and give you names because it would be unfair because previously there were 5 or 6, I could tell you all 5 and 6, all the costing, all the everything. Now there are so many people in the industry, so I would say it would be a fair chance that you do your research. I can help you in that, but then giving a specific name would be not fair to everyone. But yes, the only thing, agar aap individual ho, to aap ek ye dekh lijiye ki it's an old company jo is there in the long term because the thing is they are ready to take risks because as an individual there's a higher risk factor that is involved so agar koi established purani company hai compared to a new company they'll rather take a better risk for you and they'll give you approval quicker than a newer company but again it's you know proactive so go through reviews have an understanding yes
What are the legal implications? For example, you are a freelance web developer,
Correct.
Or you are selling digital goods online.
Correct.
Unlike a physical store, your market is whole world right
Correct.
Now. What if I just open a Bank of America account,
Correct.
Connect it to my PayPal, and set it for the open the shop for the whole world? How does the Indian government see me now? What is my relationship with RBI?
The thing is, firstly, to open a Bank of America account, you need an American SSN.
You have a partner, yeah. You have a partner, yeah.
If it's a partner, then if the company is registered there,
yeah.
then there is no question. RBI cannot question you because the company is registered there. Till the time you are showing as an Indian currency, the moment the money from the American bank comes into your account, that is when the government will question you, why is this money coming? That's your CA who will tell you how to get that money. That's something that is not related to the payment gateway actually. But then again, yes, bringing up that point, the most famous payment system across the globe has been PayPal. That's one thing I can take a call because that's the leader. It's been the longest time, it's been like the biggest name in the industry across the globe. But unfortunately, due to the RBI norms, PayPal cannot accept payments for an Indian buyer through an Indian seller. So if you're a seller in India, registered as an Indian citizen and going on PayPal and registering as an Indian buyer cannot buy products on your website from PayPal. Just a clarification. Because many people have this misconception.
What about Bitcoins?
Bitcoins is still a grey area in India. The official statement at present is no. But there, as I said, there are grey areas. So even the government doesn't know what they want or what is the situation, how to handle it.
So I have a question about rates and transfer times. What are the average rates if you can?
Rates, that was one of the points. But rates is something wherein depend, as I said, high risk factor products. Like for example, I myself having this experience, we were doing web development. Up till some 2 years back or 3 years back, the payment gateways were not very explorative. Domain registration and hosting was one of the biggest high risk products for the internet payment gateway in India. So now things have eased out, but depending on your risk category that you fall in, your rates are on that. अगर आप वेबसाइट पे जाओगे आप देखोगे कि एक एस्टैब्लिश रेट्स है वो है दे आर वेरी सेफ रेट्स सो दोज आर द रेट्स दैट दे कैन गिव यू बिकॉज दे आर हाई रिस्क फैक्टर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन देम एंड दैट्स हाउ दे कैन गिव यू बट अगर उसमें भी अगर आपका फॉर्म भरने जाओगे आपका फॉर्म भरते भरते व्हेन यू कम टू अ वैल्यू वेयर दे विल टेल यू दैट दे कैन अप्रूव और नॉट अप्रूव बिकॉज आप अगर ऑनलाइन पोर्टल पे एग्रीगेटर के या किसी के पोर्टल पे जाके रजिस्टर करते हो एवरीथिंग इज ऑन अप्रूवल इट्स फाइनेंसिस राइट इट्स ऑन अप्रूवल So there are a few, these I'll name because there are a few who have kind of tried to change the system in a way. There are products like PayUmoney, there is product like Smart.in, there are products like Paytm who have tried to make your process easier for individuals because again, the reason I'm taking names is because PayUmoney was the first provider in India to start with individual payments. They actually went and had a head-on session with RBI to explain the whole process and so that's one because of their efforts is something that will take a name they are one of the guys who provide individual payment gateways and very easy process you can go ahead and just do an online registration with them give your documentation do approval all digitally done
what about transfer times what are the
now transfer time again it depends on your package if you remember the slide there was a point where I said the select your package most of the products will give you a whenever the transfer time is basically the question of yahan pe jo pucha gaya hai transfer time okay we'll just wrap quick and we can take questions recurring payments in India is not a very comfortable option there are ways there are some aggregators who allow you but there's a special approval that you have to take So there's something not a recurring in a very straightforward way. There's something called a standing instructions. So SI, just ask your aggregator or your consultant for SI system, which is standing instructions. It is a lengthy process. It is an expensive process. It's very difficult. It's there. So which is now there's something called as ECS, which also is a part of the standing instruction logic. But standing instruction actually gets into credit card. ECS is into account, your bank account. And ECS and all these are going to change recently in the like RBI is working on it. Probably by 16 or something, you might get ACH checks in US. It's a lot famous in Europe. It's there ACH clearing. So that's something that's coming in India. RBI is working on it, how to process it and make it generalized across all banks. So that might once that comes, it's going to be much easier of internet transactions for Indians. Yeah, and including your recovery. Yes, sorry.
Hi, myself Virendra. I am an individual.
Yes.
I provide hosting and roaming registration, and I want to integrate payment gateway.
Yes.
So I asked PayUmoney for
okay.
that. They said we cannot provide these products for an individual.
How long ago had you asked this?
It's about 2 months.
Okay.
They sent me contract. I signed it, but there were a few confusions, so I asked them. After that, they said we cannot provide it to you as you are an individual. After that, they said that you need to be a private limited. They have said that they have some tools for individuals. which are allowed to take payment from.
So basically, यहाँ पे जो लोग tools का बोल रहे हैं, जैसे मैं बताया, हर एक का एक अलग system रहता है. तो इन इनकी केस में जो वो describe कर रहे हैं, ये आपके वेबसाइट से पेमेंट लेने को अलाउ नहीं करेंगे, बट उनके वेबसाइट पे आप इनवॉइस रेज करके पेमेंट कलेक्ट कर सकते हो. ओके, दीस आर द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. हमारे ईमेल भी है.
यस, क्वेश्चन इज, आर द दीस टूल्स एंड द पेमेंट गेटवे आर इक्वल इक्वली Are these equal or these are differences?
The only difference is कि आपके website से client नहीं जाता, आपको एक link भेजना पड़ता है. That's the main difference.
Okay.
So अगर आपका कोई automation process रहेगा, that might get difficult. Because the payment is collected through their website, so there are web hooks. A bit technical, but web hooks के आप automation कर सकते हो with web hooks. But then direct आपके website से the client does not move on to that
integration.
And then it would be a redirect. आप एक button रख सकते हो कि redirect and go to this payment option. And you have to manually type things or even set prepaid. These are part of contacts. The best way to get in touch with me is vachan@kdc.in. That's my email ID. You can shoot in questions. There might be some delays. I'm a bit slow in responding, but I'll definitely give you a response as soon as I can. Any questions, I'll be in the classroom below. I'll be, you can just find me and have any specific questions, I'm around town. Thanks guys. Thank you.